Hi, this is Anupam Tripathi from Fight for Animal Rights India, and today I'm here by way of this video message to share a very important and a great news for all you animal lovers across India, for all Gorakshaks across India. I have with me a copy of the judgment that we have secured from the Delhi High Court regarding illegal transportation of cattle. This judgment was secured by us in the matter of Saurabh Gupta and Gaurav Gupta versus Union of India, where I had represented these two wonderful people, these two wonderful Gorakshaks, these two wonderful animal rights activists and the leading cattle raiders in the country against illegal transport of cattle. And friends, today we have before us the judgment that I'm going to share with you of the Delhi High Court. This is a landmark, a historic judgment that will impact on a pan-India basis the cattle meat industry. This is going to impact on a pan-India basis the lives of crores of cattle all across India and the lives of lakhs of Gorakshaks, cattle protectors, cattle raiders all across India. So let me come straight to it, my friends. In this judgment, the Honorable Chief Justice of the Delhi High Court has held in Gaurav Gupta and Saurabh Gupta versus Union of India in writ petition civil number 2316 of 2017 that, and let me read it out to you, friends. And I'm going to read out verbatim for all of your convenience. This writ petition is an important issue regarding illegal transportation of cattle, which is in violation of the rules 47 to 56 of the Transport of Animal Rules 1978. These rules have been enacted in exercise of powers conferred under Section 38 of the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals Act 1960. The petitioners complain, among other, that a requisite certification from a veterinary expert is not being obtained prior to the animals being herded together in transport and moved from one place to another. Premised, among other, on the submissions, the writ petition seeks the following prayers: a writ or order or direction in the nature of mandamus or any other appropriate writ, order or direction for directing the respondents number 2, that is the Ministry of Home Affairs, respondent number 4, Ministry of Food Processing Industries, respondent number 5, Animal Welfare Board of India, for issuing notifications and guidelines to be followed by the police stations concerned in cases of illegal transport of cattle reported by them. B. Writ, order or direction in the nature of mandamus of any other appropriate writ, order or direction, including a writ of a certiorari, directing issuing guidelines that a court of magistrates are to follow in cases of illegal transport of cattle pending before them that are reported to them. Writ, order or direction in the nature of mandamus of any other appropriate writ, order or direction, directing the respondent number 1, that is Ministry of Environment and Forest, and respondent number 6, that is Ministry of Environment and Forest of the State of Delhi, and respondent number 5, that is Animal Welfare Board of India, to set up a raiding team to prevent and curb illegal transport of cattle and for enforcement of transport of animal rules 1978, my friends. A writ or order in the nature of mandamus of any other appropriate writ, order or direction for directing the Respondents Union of India through its Secretary, Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change, Ministry of Home Affairs, Ministry of Road Transport and Highways, Ministry of Food Processing Industries, Animal Welfare Board of India, Government of Delhi NCT through Secretary, etc. To the East Delhi Municipal Corporation for issuing guidelines to be followed by the slaughterhouses and to comply strictly with such guidelines or else hold them accountable and liable in cases of failure of compliance thereof. Pass such order or orders as this Honorable Court may deem fit in the facts and circumstances of this case and in the interest of justice, equity and good conscience. And then the operative portion, my friends, of the Delhi High Court, which reads as under. The High Court has said, the Honorable Delhi High Court has said in this judgment that it cannot be denied that the issues flagged by the writ petitioners are important and that the requirement with the statutory provisions of the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals Act 1960 as well as the rules 47 to 56 of the Transport of Animal Rules 1978 is mandatory. No violation thereof can be countenanced. In the counter affidavit filed by Delhi Police, a standing order number 31 of 2010, which I shall share with you soon, my friends, wide number 10001 PHQ dated 19/10/2010 has been placed before us. This standing order has been issued to ensure compliance of provisions of the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals Act 1960. The writ petitioners have pointed out that even though the standing order has been put in place and continues to bind the Delhi police, however, the same is not being complied with. The respondent number 124, Union of India, have also filed a detailed counter affidavit. A perusal thereof would show that though the reference is made to the enactment as well as to the transport of animal rules 1978, these respondents have largely referred to the order dated 13th July 2015 passed by the Supreme Court in the case of Gauri Maulekhi versus Union of India, Civil Writ Petition 881 of 2014 regarding illegal smuggling of animals from India to Nepal and not the issue of transport. Illegal transport of cattle to Delhi NCT. Additionally, references have been made to a draft notification, GSR 745E, notifying draft rules with regard to transportation of livestock, which was circulated back on 27th October 2014, without anything more having been undertaken. The respondent number 9, East Delhi Municipal Corporation, has filed the counter affidavit referring to slaughterhouses and meeting held on 16 January 2014 with regard thereto. And then Your Honor has gone on to proceed, the Delhi High Court Chief Justice has gone on to proceed in her direction, stating that it is evident from the above necessary that the necessary regime as well as the rules stand notified and are put in place. The Delhi police has also issued standing orders as back in the year 2010. However, none of the affidavits filed before us disclose any aspect of compliance with the provisions of Prevention of Cruelty to Animals Act 1960, as well as the rules 47 to 56 of the Transport of Animal Rules 1978 thereof. None of the authorities have placed before us any prosecution or punitive action against even a single person for violating these rules. To say the least, not a single instance of violation of the statutory provisions has been placed before us in the counter affidavits of the respondents. The petitioners have placed some photographs of actual instances of violations and have also referred to 21 first information reports, FIRs, registered by Delhi police regarding illegal transport of cattle. Action on these complaints deserve to be taken by the authorities. In view of the above, it is directed that the respondents shall ensure compliance of the provisions of Prevention to Cruelty to Animals Act 1960 as well as to the rules 47 to 56 of the Transport of Animal Rules. The police shall abide strictly by the requirement of the standing order of 2010. The respondent shall ensure very prompt action upon every complaint received regarding illegal transportation of animals in violation of the aforesaid legal provisions, including FIRs already registered by them. The writ petition accordingly stands disposed of in the above terms by the Chief Justice and Justice Hari Shankar, dated 15th December 2017. Writ petition civil number 2316 of 2017 of Saurabh Gupta and Gaurav Gupta versus Union of India. This is the landmark 5-page judgment, friends, that we have secured for you. This is for India. This is for the crores of cattle that are illegally transported. This is for those crores of cattle that are illegally transported, herded together in utter blatant violation of the Transport of Animal Rules, in violation of the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals Act, in violation of provisions of articles of the Constitution of India. And these poor cattle, they suffer a million deaths from one point to the other before they reach the slaughterhouse to finally be killed. These rules and this judgment now, my friends, is going to put a huge dent on the cattle meat industry, which so far has been flouting every law under the sun, every rule under the sun, just to get the margins of their profits up and up and up and up and up and up and up. Let me give you an example which this order, this judgment has said, my friends. As per the Transport of Animal Rules 1978, Rules 47 to 56, there is a mandatory requirement that there must be a veterinarian, a vet, who is going to inspect every cattle that is put for transport for purpose of slaughter. He is going to inspect that the cattle is fit for consumption by human, that the cattle is free from mad cow disease, that the cattle is free from Alzheimer's, that the cattle is free from parasites. What is happening in this country is that in 90% of the cases these cattle are transported illegally. There is no vet certificate on the in this transport. There is no vet that has inspected these cattle. They are playing with the lives of you humans, even those meat eaters who I do not like. But nevertheless, this judgment also protects all those meat eaters who eat cattle meat. Why? Because you, so far, the meat that you were eating in this country, later when you turned 45, 50, 55, little did you realize, where did Alzheimer's hit you from? Where did mad cow hit you from? What happened to your health? Why did you get cancer? It's because all this meat was bad meat. All this meat was not being inspected by a vet who was certifying that this meat was fit for your consumption. Why? Because this cattle meat industry, the exports alone of which are 30,000 crore worth or $6 billion worth, and the domestic consumption is more than a lakh of crores or more than $15 billion. It is because they want the margins up. They want more profits, more profits. They are eating out of this blood money and making more profits, more profits, more profits, not just by killing cattle, by committing cruelty on it, killing them, hacking them to death, but also by playing with your lives. Do you know, my friends, let me share this with you, United States of America, Europe, Australia, and all the developed nations in the world have started to deny the meat being exported, cattle meat, beef being exported to these countries from India. You know why? Exactly for this reason. These countries have realized that in our country they flout the rules and the laws for the safety of human as well as for the protection from cruelty of the animals. They have realized that all this cattle meat has Alzheimer's in it, this much full, has mad cow in it, this much full, has parasites in it, this much full. Our meat now only goes to the South East Asian countries and Middle East and Bangladesh and Sri Lanka and Pakistan and God knows where all. It does not anymore. It is denied by European Union. It is denied by United States. It is denied by Australia. It is denied by all developed nations because they flout the rules. This judgment, my friends, this historic, this landmark judgment now will put a lid on it. On all these illegalities. It will dent these profit margins of these people. Let me share with you an example. Now, if they employed vets to inspect every cattle, more vets will get employment, more vets will have to be paid salaries. More of these vets will ensure that the cattle being transported for slaughter is fit for human consumption. Our meat will get credibility when it is exported to the international market. So far that has not been happening. Though I am against the cattle meat industry, I am against anybody who eats meat, and I would like them all and the whole world to turn vegetarian. But till that happens, my friends, your health also needs to be protected. I am not just fighting for the cruelty on the cattle, I am fighting for your health. And this order, this judgment, this historic judgment reflects just that. Let me give you another example. Rules 47 to 56 talk about the total number of cattle that can be put on a truck. The largest possible truck can only have a maximum of 8 adult cattle in them. 8 big buffaloes, 8 big bulls, or 16 calves max. Medium size, 6 adult cattle. Smaller size, 4 adult cattle. How many have actually transported? Do you know, friends? 40, 50, 80 of them in one single truck. They divide it, they make it a double trekker truck, and they dump these cattle, 70 full of them. By the time they reach the slaughterhouse, 50% of them have died out of suffocation, have died in their own blood, their own stool and own urine. Why do they do that? To get their profit margins higher. To get their margins higher and higher and higher. By doing so, what do? They save on driver costs. They save on fuel costs. And hence they get their profits up and up and up and up. This cattle meat industry has been violating for donkey years every rule and every law under the sun just to get their profit margins up, to make more money for themselves and their families and their loved ones at the cost of these poor animals who die out of suffocation in their own blood, stool and urine. And not just that, my friends, as I stated earlier, as I told you, they have been playing with your health. All you meat eaters in this country and abroad, remember, to my friends abroad, if they are eating any meat being transported or any meat being exported from India, remember, these rules have been flouted. The judgment makes it very clear. This meat is full of parasites. This meat is full of Alzheimer's and mad cow. Don't eat the meat exported from India. It has flouted every rule possible. To my friends here, the meat eaters here in India who by any chance eat cattle meat, there are 3 or 4 states, unfortunately, who still allow for cattle slaughter, for cow slaughter, which too I'm going to fight next. And in a year's time, I'm assuring you all, I will put an end to that as well. Because in a country that belongs to the Ram, the avatar of Ram was Lord Krishna, and Krishna and his relation with the holy cow, everybody is very well known. Cow is a religious subject for us. Cow is a subject that is covered under Article 25 to 28, my religious freedoms. Religious freedoms of 90 crore Hindu population in this country. And in this land of the Hindus, 90 crore Hindus, in this land of India, in the land of Lord Krishna, in the land of Ram, cow cannot be allowed to be slaughtered. 25 states don't allow it to be slaughtered. 4 states allow it to be slaughtered. These 4 states have to amend their law, and slaughtering of cow needs to be banned in these states too. This would be Anupam Tripathi, FFAR India's next fight. In a year's time, I will put a lid on it. I will not allow these 4 states to continue with cow slaughter. Not in the land of the holy Ram, not in the land of the holy Krishna. Cow is Gau Mata. Cow is religious for 90 crore Hindus in this country and for another 25 crore Hindus all across the world. Cow is a religious subject. It's covered directly under Article 25 to 28 of the Constitution of India. That shall be my argument going forward. This shall be my next big fight. And in a year's time, I will have these 4 states declare cow slaughter to be illegal. I will not let it happen in my country. Cow cannot be allowed to be slaughtered in my country. So anyways, not to go away from the current, the historic, the landmark judgment that we have secured, my friends. I wanted to share this judgment, this order with you. And now going forward, my message to all the animal rights activists, all the cattle raiders, all the animal rights activists who have been fighting for cattle, I would like you to know that going forward, with effect from today or with effect from 15th December 2017, the date of this judgment, which now we have finally secured because it's out in the public platform, I would like all of you to know that any point in time going forward that you find trucks filled with cattle exceeding more than 4, 6 or 8 adult cattle, 8, 12 or 16 calves, that truck is illegally transporting cattle. You, with the assistance of the police of the nearest station, can stop this transport, confiscate these people's property, which is illegal, hand it over to an SPCA or to an NGO immediately so that the cattle can get the veterinarian help and the medical help. And police has to register a FIR in such cases and investigate and take action and produce the culprits transporting illegally these cattle before the magistrate. If the police refuses to lodge an FIR or register a complaint, my friends, remember, it's writ petition, civil number 2316 of 2017, in the matter of Gaurav Gupta and Saurabh Gupta versus Union of India, represented by Anupam Tripathi of FFAR India. This 5-page judgment will give you the power and will equip you going forward for the police to act and the authorities to act. This is your judgment. Remember, friends, this judgment doesn't just belong to me. It doesn't just belong to Saurabh Gupta or Gaurav Gupta. This judgment belongs to India. This judgment belongs to every animal rights activist out there, every Gorakshak out there, every NGO out there who works for protection of cattle against illegal transport. You get the copy of this judgment from me, or from Saurabh Gupta, or from Gaurav Gupta, or from Delhi High Court directly from its website, and keep it with you handy in your car. And at all times when you go for cattle raiding against illegal transport, to protect the lives of cattle, to protect the lives of the cow, this judgment would come in handy. This judgment is going to force the authorities, including the police, to take action, to register your complaint, to register an FIR, to apprehend the culprits, to produce them before the magistrate the next day, to take action. This judgment will ensure that the provisions of Rules 47 to 56 of Transport of Animal Rules are no longer violated. This judgment will ensure that police takes prompt action. This judgment will ensure that the police, after noting down the complaint and registering the FIR, are going to immediately, after taking photographs and video and making a count of the number of cattle on the truck, have to release this truck to an SPCA or any NGO that can take custody of these cattle in the interim and provide medical help to these cattle who are dying at the time. This judgment equips you with all of that. This judgment is not just Delhi NCT valid. It's going to operate pan India. So anywhere where you are in this country and cattle is being transported illegally, more than 8 in number if they are adult cattle, more than 16 in number if they are calves, in the largest possible truck or in a medium truck, more than 6 in number adult cattle, or in a smaller truck, more than 4 in number adult cattle, that truck is illegally transporting cattle, my friends. It is illegally transporting cattle contrary to the rules, contrary to this judgment. And you as activists have the right then to assist with the assistance of the police to stop this truck, to apprehend it, to file a complaint, to get the FIR registered, to have the police confiscate the property and send it immediately, all these cattle, to an NGO or to an SPCA, so that the cattle can get the required medical help and attention. And the police then are to produce the culprits the very next day before the magistrate and proceed with the case against them under 428, 429 of Indian Penal Code, and under provisions of Section 3 and 11 of Prevention of Cruelty to Animals Act, and for provisions of violating Rules 47 to 56 of Transport of Animal Rules. This judgment will come in handy, my friends. This is the big historic landmark judgment for all of you, for all of India, for the cattle in this country, crores of them, for the lakhs of animal rights activists. This is for you, India. This is for you. This is for you. If you have any questions for me as to how to procure this judgment from me, or any questions or any clarification that you would like to seek from me regarding this matter, this judgment, this historic judgment we have secured, this great judgment that we have secured regarding illegal transport of cattle, you can ask me all those questions and I'll be glad to respond to your queries in the comments column of this video below, my friends. If you have any additional questions, you can also email me. The details of my email, etc., are all in the description of this video below. And finally, friends, you should know, if you have not yet subscribed to my YouTube channel, subscribe now. Hit the red button which says subscribe. Next to it is a bell icon. Click that too for notifications. And continue to show your love, support to my organization, Fight for Animal Rights India. And friends, I would like all of you to know also that Fight for Animal Rights India is going to continue its work, its fight for social causes, environment, and our animals. And we will not stop. We will not stop. In January 2018, friends, another 4 or 6 petitions of ours are coming up, which need your help, which need your support. Our tiger petition comes back in Supreme Court on 4th of January, so does our wild boar petition. We need your contributions, we need your help, we need your generosity. Show your generosity. How you can contribute and donate to my NGO? It's all in the description of this video. Go ahead and start donating now. If you want us, if you want to support us and help us continue our fight zealously and win each time, just like we've won here. There are other petitions as well, very interesting ones that are coming up. We are fighting for the Asiatic Lions of Girnar in Gir in Gujarat, who are in trouble because of some construction work of a university that's going on there, friends. We will soon be in Supreme Court regarding that. You should support us there. We have other PILs as well. See which issue, which matter, which campaign of ours is something you feel more closer to, you would like to support and contribute to, and go ahead and generously and kindly donate to my NGO for this purpose. A lot of people out there, we have a lot of haters who are jealous of us, who are jealous of my work and the results I'm bringing in. They are going to tell you all kinds of nonsense. They will tell you this, they will tell you that, they will tell you this, they will tell you that. How and try and jeopardize my campaign, fundraiser campaigns. But all I will say is, after all their hoo-ha, 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 my friends, the judgments are being secured by me. The results are being secured by my NGO. My NGO. I am fighting for the tigers. I am fighting for the wild boars. I am fighting for the cattle. I am fighting for the birds of India. I am fighting for the dogs of India. I am fighting for the Nilgai. I am fighting against Aurangzeb. I am fighting for clean up Yamuna. I am fighting for clean up Ganga. I am fighting for freeing Tihar from overpopulation. I am fighting for the students of India who are dying in these schools. I am fighting against soldier suicides. This is all the work of my NGO. We are the ones who are working relentlessly. We are the ones who are fighting for you. We are the ones who are bringing you the results. While all these haters, they're going to tell you all these things. Ask them, what have they done in the last 3 years? Have they done even 100th in the last 10 years of what we have done in the last 3? Ask them that. And then ask them to shut up and then open your wallets, open your bank accounts and generously and kindly donate to us. Contribute to my organization, to my NGO. All contributions, donations made by you to my NGO have tax benefits as well, friends. My NGO is a Section 80G and a Section 12AA under Income Tax Act registered. It's recognized as 100% charity, working for social causes, environment and animal rights. All donations made by you are tax exempt. Make your contribution today to our next campaign and the 4 or 5 campaigns coming up in January. We need your help. My animals need your help. My NGO needs your help. I need your help. You continue to support me and I'll continue to bring you orders after orders and judgments after judgments in favor of Earth, in favor of our environment, in favor of our animals. Thank you for your love. My NGO needs your contributions. I am not PETA. I am not HSI. I am not these big NGOs that get millions and millions and millions and millions of funds and have nothing to show for it. I am Anupam Tripathi. I'm a social activist and an animal rights activist. My jurisdiction is not just extending to New Delhi or India. My jurisdiction is the globe. Wherever there is injustice, wherever the environment needs saving, wherever our animal needs saving, you will find me there. I will keep fighting and I will not stop. But my NGO, FFAR India, needs your contributions. It needs your help. It needs you to show your generosity. Contribute today. Donate today. Thank you, and Jai Hind.